Barbara.
Hey, Joe.
You ready to get started?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, so today I'm going to show you how to do a CHG bath. Have you ever done one before?
No, what's a CHG bath?
Okay, well, actually, we should call it a treatment.
A treatment?
Yeah, you'll see why. Come on.
Okay.
So, CHG, or chlorhexidine gluconate, is an antiseptic agent that is effective against a wide range of bacteria, including both gram-positive and gram-negative organisms. It's more effective than soap and water at keeping germs off the skin. Once applied to the skin, it can kill germs up to 24 hours. And it is a very important procedure in preventing the spread of infection.
Okay. Well, so how often does a patient receive this kind of treatment?
Every 24 hours. But sometimes CHG bathing is required once as preparation for operations and procedures.
Okay, that makes sense.
Okay, so we're gonna get started. First, I'm going to show you the basics on the training mannequin, and then we can start working on some patients.
Okay. Hey there, friend. What's your name?
I like to call him Bert.
Hi, Bert.
So, we'll need at least 6 chlorhexidine wipes to complete an entire CHG treatment. Okay, but you can use as many as you need. Let's say you have a larger surface area or a lot of lines, tubes, or drains. Mm. Now, we also have these bathing wipes, and these can be used on the face because CHG shouldn't get into a patient's ears and eyes. And these can also be used for incontinence to clean up soiled areas.
Got it.
Okay, so before you get started, first, hand hygiene.
Yep.
And a fresh pair of gloves. Some patients may be tired or too weak and may just not want to bathe, but we have to make it clear that this is not just a bath, but a very important part of their treatment.
Okay.
So, if you have any questions, feel free to stop me at any time.
Will do.
There are 6 zones that need to be wiped with at least 1 fresh wipe. Zone 1, neck, chest, abdomen, and groin. Zone 2 and 3, right and left arm. Zone 4 and 5, right and left leg. Zone 6, the back.
And so I use a new wipe for each zone?
Absolutely. And it's important to let the skin air dry for about a minute and not wipe off the CHG with a towel or rinse it with water. The skin will be sticky for a few minutes, but that's okay. The CHG wipe should be the last wipe to the skin. Do you understand why?
To protect from infection for the required 24 hours?
Right. All right, let's get started with zone 1, the neck, chest, abdomen, and groin. Now, generally, we start with the top and work our way to the bottom. Make sure that you thoroughly clean the creases and folds of the skin. Pay special attention to the neck because of its proximity to the lines, drains, and devices. The neck can be filled with bacteria. And we finish by cleaning the groin area.
Is it safe to use in the perineal area?
Yes, safe and necessary. Next, we move on to zones 2 and 3, the right and the left arm. We move again from the top to the bottom. And once we're done with one arm, we clean the other with one new wipe. All right, and now that we've finished the arms, we can get the patient a fresh gown. All right, now that he has a fresh gown, we move on to zone 4 and 5. You get a new wipe for each leg. Once we're done here, we move on to zone 6, the back. We start from the back of the neck, and making sure we clean well between all of the creases and folds, and then we wipe the back, and finally, the buttocks. Okay, should we change the sheets now? I like to say clean patient, clean gown, clean bed. All right, so the final part of the CHG treatment is to clean the lines. But first, you do need to do hand hygiene again before we get started wiping the lines. We get a fresh wipe, start with the central line. With central lines and IVs, always start closest to the insertion site and work your way out at least 6 inches. Some patients can give themselves a CHG bath, but they should never try to clean their own lines. Line care should always be done by a nurse to make sure it is done correctly and that the lines are not pulled out by mistake. Each line gets a new wipe. Lastly, we'll clean the Foley catheter and make sure we do it last. Start closest to the patient and wipe away again 6 inches. Now we can say the CHG treatment is complete and old Bert here can get some rest. Do you have any questions?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Oh, and don't flush any wipes in the toilet.
Okay.
All right. Now we can go work on some real patients.